Welcome learners, in the series of videos on topology. We are talking about separable spaces. In the previous video, we have proved that open subspace of a separable space is separable and the product of two separable spaces is also separable. So let's prove today that continuous image, so theorem, let us show that continuous image of separable space is separable. So continuous image of separable space is separable. Okay, let us prove this. So for that we will have a space say X, which is separable. Another space we have Y. We have a function f from x to y, which is continuous function. So if this f is surjective, then fx is equals to whole of y, and we can simplify over. But if f is not surjective, then fx will be a subset of x. So this is our fx. If fx equals to y, that means it is surjective function. Okay, so let us prove this. Proof. Now we know that this X is separable space. Okay, so let X be separable space. Let me write X and Y to topological spaces first. Let X and Y be two topological spaces such that our X is separable. And let us take f be a function from X to Y, be continuous function, continuous map. Be continuous map. Okay. Now claim. We are claiming that fx is separable. So if it's onto, then we are done. Almost we don't have to worry about much calculation part. But let us assume that it is not surjective. Okay. So we will go with the subspace topology out there. Okay, so we'll talk about subspace topology inside that. So now, since X is separable, there exists countable dense subset. Say, let us take D. Okay, D is a countable dense subset of X. So let the image of D, that is f of D, is equals to D1. So continuous image of a countable set is countable. Okay, so this implies D1 is countable in Y. Okay, so D1 is countable. Of course, doesn't matter where you are taking D, this in Y or fx, this has countably many points. So if you take any space, it will be countably many points. So we know that D1 is countable. Let us show that this D1 is dense in fx. Let us show that D1 is dense in fx. So let us take a open set in fx. So now let V be open in fx. We will show that D intersection V is non-empty. Okay, D1 intersection V is non-empty. This is D1. d1 is table in y. So we will show that d1 intersection v is non-empty and we are done. Okay, so now v is open in fx since v is open in fx as a subspace topology implies there exists say a open set say u in y such that this v can be written as u intersection fx. Okay, as a subspace topology. Now since u is open in y, f is continuous, since u is open in y and f is continuous implies f inverse of u is open in x because of by the definition of continuity. Okay, inverse image of open set is open. Now this implies f inverse of u is open in x, and as we know d is dense in x. Okay, since d is dense in x, this implies d intersection with f inverse of u is a non-empty set. And first of all, let us take a non-empty set here. V be open in x, v a non-empty. Okay, let us take a non-empty set. Here, v non-empty. So since this d intersection f at u, f inverse of u is non-empty, this implies there exists a point in here, right? So let us take small d. D belongs to d intersection f inverse of u. So since this d is in the intersection, this implies d belongs to d and d belongs to inverse image of u. So d belongs to d implies fd belongs to fd, that is equals to d1, right? And this implies fd belongs to u because the d is in the inverse image, that means image of this d will be in u. So now since we have this implies this fd belongs to d1, so fd belongs to u intersection with fx, because of course that will be in fx, right, which is equals to v also, right? Fd belongs to u here, from here fd belongs to u. Let me write that, otherwise there may be confusion. So this implies from here, this implies f belongs to, or fd belongs to d1 and fd belongs to u intersection with fx, because it's an image set and u intersection fx is our v is equals to u intersection fx. So this is equals to v, and hence this implies fd belongs to v intersection d1, and this implies v intersection d1 is non-empty. And hence by theorem we can say that this implies d1 is dense in fx. And hence we already proved that d1 is countable. This implies fx is separable because we proved that it has countable dense set. So the continuous image of a separable space is separable. Okay, let us take one two examples more. Let us take let me write here itself. This is done. As an example, let me write example. Let us take x be with discrete topology. Discrete topology. When this discrete topology will be countable, separable. Okay, and for this we have x is separable if and only if x is countable. First part we already proved, already done, because if x is countable and already we know that x is dense in itself, so then x will be the countable dense set and hence x is separable. So proving that x is countable implies x is separable, that is not a big problem. Now, prove that if x is separable and x is with discrete topology, show that x is countable. I repeat, if x is separable and x is with discrete topology, show that x is countable. So, let me keep this as an exercise. Another theorem, small 2-4 line statements of proof. So let us write theorem. Every second countable space, every second countable space, say X is separable. Okay, remember this statement. In the next statement, in the next theorem also we are using this. So if we have any countable space, second countable space, then that space is always separable. And to find the countable dense set, we will make the use of the space that is second countable. Okay, so let me prove this very 3-4 lines. So let us complete this itself here. So let X be separable, X be second countable space. So let X be second countable space. Okay, so if X is second countable, that means there exists a countable basis. Okay, so let us take Bn such that this n belongs to n, be countable basis. Okay, now basis for X, let us write for X. Now from this countable basis we will get the countable dense set. Okay, now since we have basis, this is non-empty sets, so let us take one element from this set. So let say t1, let me take b, because b a will take. So let b1 belongs to b1, so from this b1 which is non-empty set we will take b1. Let the b2 belongs to the capital b2. Likewise, let us take bn from the set Bn for all n belonging to n. So let us take Bn from Bn which belongs to Bn for all n belongs to natural numbers. And let us take now let D, set D is equal to set of all those elements Bn. So Bn n belongs to natural number. Also we know it's very simple, D is countable, we know that. By using this definition itself, D is countable. Right? D is countable. And we need to show that D is dense in X. Claim D is dense in X. So, to show that D is dense in X, let us take a basic neighborhoods and take the intersection with the D. It should be non-empty. Okay? So, now just one line you can see here, since bn or bn naught belongs to D intersection bn naught, right, for all n naught in n, you take any natural number n naught, bn naught will be D intersection bn naught. This implies D intersects every basic neighborhood. basic elements, basic open standards, right? Open sets, right? Because this Bn are the basic elements. So Bn, this D intersects every basic element, and hence this implies D is dense in X. And hence, since D is dense in X, we can say that X is separable. So every second countable space is separable. Okay. Now in the next statement, next theorem, we will show that every separable metric space is second countable. I repeat, in the next video we will show that every separable, here we prove that second countable space is separable. But if we have a separable metric space, then this is second countable. So that will be our aim in the next video. So stay tuned and see you in the next video.